Good morning students, all are welcome to the social science class. Hope all are fine at home. Today we are taking our social science class. Before that, let me introduce your textbook. This is our textbook, and already you know that these are divided into three parts. First is for history, and second for geography, and third for political science or civics. These three parts. Today we are taking the civics or the political science part of our social science textbook. I think all are met with the basic concepts of political science, like Constitution of India, and what is its importance, and election process, such like that, and also the governments, what are the forms of governments, etc. Today we are discussing about the topic equality. What is it? Equality. Our chapter name is on equality. Before entering to our chapter, let me invite your attention to three different areas. One is a polling booth. What is it? Polling booth. Second one is a public distribution system. What is it? Public distribution system. Third one is a government hospital or primary health center. What is it? Primary health center. These are the three locations we have to trace for entering to our topic on equality. For these three areas, we can see a common thing. Do you know what is it? It is a queue of persons who are waiting for their chances. So we select the first one. What is it? It is a polling booth. What is the name of a polling booth? It is to prepare the conveniences or the settings for an election process. The people who are entering to the polling booth or in front of the polling booth, for what they are waiting? To cast their vote. Here the aim of people is to cast their vote. Cast vote. To cast vote. Second is the public distribution system. What is a public distribution system? It is to provide the food grains or the necessary commodities for the public or the people. Here the aim of the people who were coming to the ration stores or the Maveli stores. These are the examples for this public distribution system. That is the PDS. The aim is to buy food grains or the necessary commodities. To buy food grains. To buy food grains. Third is primary health center. What is it? Primary health center. Here, for what the people are coming? It is to consult a doctor, to consult a specified doctor, to consult doctor. These are the three common, or these are the three different areas for getting our topic equality. We can say that here we can see queues of the people who were waiting for their chances. And the one thing we have to remember is that there is no overlapping. All the people are patiently waiting for their chances, and there is no overlapping, no consideration for any people who were from the higher class or educated people, rich people, or in a higher caste or anything like that. There is no consideration or no preference for such people, but instead of that, all are waiting patiently for their chances. So we can say that the term equality is concerned with equal position or equal status of the people in different sections of society. What we say? Equality means equal positions of the people in different sections of society, whether may be a polling booth or may be a public distribution system or anything like a primary health center or a government hospital or anything providing the public opportunities for the people. Then the definition of equality. Equality is definition of equality. Definition of equality. What does equality mean? It is the to reduce the gap. Equality is to reduce the gap between two individuals or more. What is it? If equality can be defined as, it is the concept aims to reduce or minimize the gap between two individuals or more. There is no consideration for any individuals irrespective of caste, creed, sex, religion, anything like that. All are equal in the eyes of law or before the law. All are equal before the law. This is the term equality. Definition. What is it? Aims to reduce the gap between two or more individuals. We can say that there are three parameters or three types of equality which existed in our society. What is it? Parameters of equality. Parameters of equality. First one is political equality. What is it? Political equality. Political equality means equal position of the people in the affairs of state, or the state have, so or the people have equal right to participate in the affairs of state. It is the political equality. It includes the following points, that is the right to vote. Second is equal rights in the public affairs. Here it is the most important concept or most important factor related to political equality, and this term we can say as a constitutional provision, or the constitution provides the right to vote within the term of a concept. What you know what is it? It is called as, or the right to vote is called as universal adult franchise. What is it? Universal adult franchise. So the right to vote is called as universal adult franchise. Universal adult franchise. It can be defined, or it can be explained as all the Indian citizens having 18 years or more, the right to interfere or right to enter to the public matters or affairs of society. What is the age limit? 18 years and above. The people having 18 years and above have the right to interfere or have the right to enter into the public affairs or the affairs of the state. The best example is the right to vote. It is the right to vote. By this, the people are selecting their candidates according to their preferences. There is no compulsion or no any outsiders interference in the matters of a of an individual, and the individual has his own preference or choices to select a candidate at the time of election. This is the political equality. I repeat, it is the right to vote or and also the right to engage or right to enter into the public affairs, and the right to vote we can say another term, that is universal adult franchise. Then the all the democratic countries are favorable for this political equality, and they following one principle. Do you know what is it? All the democratic countries including India, they are favorable of this political equality, or they are in favor of this political equality. They following one principle, that is one vote then one person and one value. What is it? One vote, one person, one value. It means every preference of individual or the preference of each individual has its own importance. In the term vote, we can say that in an election process, the selection of the candidate by every individual has its own importance, and it may be made by one person, and all preferences have same value, whether may be an educated citizen who cast in his vote, and that may be a poor sections of people who they're casting their votes. So all votes or all selection procedures in an election process have equal importance, and there is no special preference for any person from any caste, creed, sex, religion, education, anything. There is no special consideration to anyone. All are equal in the eyes of law. This is the first parameter. What is it? Political equality. Then the second is economic equality. What is it? Economic equality. It means all persons are equal in the society because they get equal opportunities to earn money, or they get equal opportunities in the society. By this we mean all the people have equal opportunities in the society. Anyway, there may be some unequal experiences, like in the case of income, education and civic facilities are different. There may be differences in that areas. Let us examine. In the case of income, we can say what is income. There may be two sections. What are they? Rich people and the poor people. In the case of education, what we can say? There may be educated people and uneducated. Educated and uneducated. Then, in the case of civic facilities, we can say that they are also getting less civic facilities. Civic facilities means citizen who consider as most important to our state. In this we can trace the example of the scheduled caste or other backward communities. They are getting less chance for the affairs of state. Somehow they don't know about what are the things of election, or how we select the candidate, or what are the benefits for them from the parts of government. They have less knowledge about the political matters. So we can say that some of the people have less aware of the civic facilities that may be obtained to them by the state. This is the economic equality. Second parameter is economic equality. In this we can say that all the people are treated equal in the eyes of law or in the society because they get equal opportunities in the society. But in reality, there may be the different sections on the basis of income, education, then civic facilities, then other political benefits enjoyed by the people. Then the third parameter is social equality. What is it? Social equality. Social equality means it is the duty of the state to ensure the equal opportunity or equal participation of the people for the benefits of society like goods and burdens. What is it? Equal opportunities. Equal opportunities in goods and burdens. Goods and burdens. And burdens. These things are included like income, education, health care, etc. So, social equality means it is the duty of the state to provide equal opportunities for all citizens for getting the goods and burdens of the society. Or in another term, we can say that all the people have to enjoy equal benefits or the benefits from the society in an equal manner. This is the third parameter, social equality. I repeat, it is the equal opportunity of the goods and burdens enjoyed by the people in a society, it including the things like income, education, health care, etc. And it is the state which have to provide the health care and also the educational facilities for all sections of the society in a proper and equal manner. This is the third parameter. Today we discuss the three parameters of the equality and what is its definition like that. When we see in our textbook, we call a girl, that is, her name is what? Well, we can, let us see our textbook, that chapter, that is equality, and we can say that a girl and her brother, both are waiting for their chances. What is it? Both are waiting for their chances in a polling booth, but they are waiting for their parents not to cast their own vote, but they were waiting for their parents. Here the girl name is Nini, and she and her brother were waiting for their parents while they are in the polling booth. This is the chapter equality, and today we discuss three parameters of equality. Then do you know the preamble, the term preamble of Indian Constitution? What is the feature or the speciality of preamble, or in what term we call the preamble? We can say the preamble is the introductory part. Preamble is the introductory part of Indian Constitution. Preamble is the introductory part of Indian Constitution. Introductory part. I mentioned this here for how to formulate our topic equality, or how the equality become an important concept of our Indian Constitution. Equality is the introductory part of Indian Constitution, and we can read the preamble is the introductory part of our Constitution, and we can read the preamble as. Have you ever read the preamble, or have you know about the preamble? Let me read, okay? We the people of India, having solemnly resolved to constitute our country into a sovereign, secular, democratic republic, and also to secure its citizens justice, liberty, equality, fraternity and integrity. These are the terms that mentioned in the preamble of our constitution. And here we remember, or we mentioned the term equality, where to secure the people's justice or secure the citizens of India or secure the country's citizens' justice, equality, liberty, fraternity and integrity. So we can say that equality is the important term that is mentioned in the constitution, Indian constitution. Just check in which part equality is mentioned. For that purpose, our preamble is divided into four parts. And the third part, we just take the third part only. The third part is the object of constitution. Parts of preamble. There are four parts. Here we take the preamble here we take the term equality from the objects of constitution, where objectives of constitution. And from this part we select the term equality. And the objectives of constitution is concerned with three rights or three factors. They are justice, liberty, equality. And one more thing also add, that is fraternity. The objectives of constitution concerned with four factors. What are they? Justice, liberty, equality and fraternity. And we can say that the three, these parts, liberty and equality, are the contributions of French Revolution. French Revolution. That may you have studied in your higher classes, okay? Liberty, equality and fraternity are the contributions of French Revolution, or in another term we can say that these three terms are taken from the French Revolution. And also, do you know where or in which constitution we take the term preamble? Anyone know? Yes, what in which constitution? From the Constitution of USA we take the term preamble. From the Constitution of USA. Constitution of USA. Here we take the term preamble. The preamble is taken from the Constitution of USA. So these are the things we deal in today's class. Let me conclude. What is it? What is equality and what are its parameters? And from which part equality is taken? These are the things we discussed. So let me conclude this. Like equality, its parameters. What are they? Political equality. Second one is economic equality. Third one is social equality. These are the three important things we discussed today. What are they? What is equality? Then what are the three parameters of equality? Hope all get this concept clearly. If you have any doubt, call me personally. So dear students, have a nice day.